Huang Chao was the leader of a major agrarian rebellion that, during the last decade of his life, seriously weakened the Tang dynasty. Well-educated, Huang first became a salt smuggler, before joining Wang Xiangji's rebellion in the mid-870s. After splitting with Wang, his army pillaged and committing the Guangzhou massacre. In 881, his troops captured the capital Chang'e, forcing Emperor Zizong of Tang to flee. Huang proclaimed himself the Qi Emperor, but was defeated by the Tang army led by the Shachua chieftain Li Qiong in 883 and forced to desert Chang'e. Following successive defeats, including by former subordinates Zhu Wen and Shang Rang who surrendered to Tang, Huang was killed by his nephew Lin Yan. Background. The Tang dynasty, established in 618 AD, had already passed its golden age and entered its long decline beginning with the Enlushan rebellion by Sogdian general Enlushan. The power of the Jiaduxi or provincial military governors increased greatly after imperial troops crushed the rebels. The discipline of these generals also decayed as their power increased. The resentment of common people against the incapacity of the government grew, and the grievances exploded into several rebellions during the mid-9th century. Many impoverished farmers, tax-burdened landowners and merchants, as well as many large salt smuggling operations, formed the base of the anti-government rebellions of this period. Wang Xiangji and Huang Chao were two of the important rebel leaders during this era. It is not known when Huang was born, but it is known that he was from Yuanzhu. His family had been salt privateers for generations, and the Huang family became wealthy from smuggling. It was said that Huang was capable in swordsmanship, riding, and archery, and was somewhat capable in writing and rhetoric. He used his wealth to take in desperate men who then served under him. He had at least one older brother, Huang Kun, and at least six younger brothers, Huang Yi or Huang Xia, Huang Kui, Huang Qin, Huang Bing, Huang Wantuang, and Huang Sihao. He repeatedly participated in the imperial examinations, but was not able to pass them, and thereafter resolved to rebel against Tang rule. As rebel, joining forces with Wang Xiangji late in the Xiantong era of Emperor Yizong, there were severe droughts and floods that caused terrible famine. Despite this, the Tang imperial government largely ignored the victims of these natural disasters, instead of granting tax exemptions for affected areas. Taxes were increased to fund Emperor Yizong's luxurious lifestyle and military campaigns. As a result, survivors grouped themselves into bands and rose to resist Tang rule. In 874, Wang Xiangji and Shang Zhengzhang rose an army at Shang Yuan. By 875 he had repeatedly defeated Zhu Chong in battle, the military governor of Tianping Circuit. Huang had by this point also raised several thousand men, and joined forces with Wang's now veteran troops. By this time Emperor Yizong had died and his young son Emperor Zizong ruled. Late in 876, Wang was sought to parlay his victories into a peaceful submission to Tang authority, in which he would be generously treated by the throne. This was being mediated by Tang official Wang Liao, a close relation to Chancellor Wang Duo, and Pei Wo, the prefect of Qi Prefecture. Under Wang Duo's insistence, Emperor Zizong commissioned Huang Xiangji, an officer of the Imperial Left Shen's army, and delivered the commission to Qi Prefecture. However, Huang, who did not receive a commission as part of this arrangement, angrily stated, "When we started the rebellion, we made a grand oath and we have marched through great distances with you. Now, you are going to accept this office and go to the Left Shen's army. What should these 5,000 men do?" He battered Huang Xiangji on the head, and the rebel soldiers also clamored against the arrangement. Wang Xiangji, fearing the wrath of his own army, turned against Pei and pillaged Qi Prefecture. However, afterwards, the rebel army broke up into two groups, with one group following Wang Xiangji and Shang Zhengzhang, and one group following Huang. Subsequent departure from Wang, Huang Chao subsequently roamed throughout central China, and his campaign took him into many engagements with Tang forces. In spring 877, Huang captured Tianping's capital Yun Prefecture, killing Zuchong, and then captured Yi Prefecture. In summer 877, he joined forces with Shang Zhengzhang's brother Shang Rang at Mount Chia. He and Wang Xiangji then briefly joined forces again and put the Tang general Song Wei under siege at Song Prefecture. However, the Tang general Zhang Zimian then arrived and defeated him, and they lifted the siege on Song Prefecture and scattered. In winter 877, he pillaged Qi and Huang prefectures. The Tang general Zheng Yuani defeated him, however, and he fled. He soon captured Quang Cheng and Pu Prefecture. In spring 878, Huang was sieging Bo Prefecture, when Wang Xiangji was crushed by Zheng at Huang Mai and killed. Shang Rang took the remnants of Wang's army and joined Huang at Bo Prefecture, and he offered the title of king to Huang. Huang, instead, claimed the title of Chongshan Dajiang Jun and changed the era name to Wang Ba, to show independence from the Tang regime. He then captured Yi and Pu prefectures again, but then suffered several defeats by Tang forces. He thus wrote the new military governor of Tianping, Zhang Shi, asking Zhang to ask for a Tang commission on his behalf. At Zhang's request, Emperor Zizong commissioned Huang as a general of the Imperial Guards, but ordered him to report to Yun Prefecture to disarm before he would report to the capital Chang'e. Faced with those conditions, Huang refused the offer. Instead, he attacked Song and Bian prefectures, and then attacked Wainan, and then Yi and Yangzhai. Emperor Zizong thus commissioned troops from three circuits to defend the eastern capital Luoyang, and further ordered Zheng to head to Luoyang as well. With the Tang forces concentrating on defending Luoyang, Huang marched south instead. Marched to Lingnan, Huang Chao crossed the Yangtze River south and captured several prefectures south of the Yangtze, Qian, Ji, Rao, and Xin. In fall 878, he then headed northeast and attacked Shan Prefecture, defeating Wang Ning, the governor of Shan's circuit at Nanling, but could not capture Shan Prefecture, and therefore further headed southeast to attack Zhedong Circuit, and then, via a mountainous route, Fujian Circuit in winter 878. However, during this march, he was attacked by the Tang officers Zhang Lin and Liang Zuan, who were subordinates of Gao Pian, the military governor of Zhenhai Circuit, and defeated several times. As a result of these battles, a number of Wang's followers, including Qin Yan, Bai Shijue, Lihangji, and Zhu Qing, surrendered to the Zhenhai troops. As a result, Huang decided to turn further south toward the Lingnan region. By this point, Wang Duo had volunteered to oversee the operations against Huang, and Wang was thus made the overall commander of the operations as well as the military governor of Dingyan Circuit. In reaction to Wang's movement, he commissioned Li Shi to be his deputy commander, as well as the governor of Hunan Circuit, in order to block a potential northerly return route for Huang. Meanwhile, Huang wrote Sui Qiu, the governor of Zhedong Circuit, and Li Tiao, the military governor of Lingnan East Circuit, to ask them to intercede for him, offering to submit to Tang imperial authority if he were made the military governor of Tianping. Sui and Li Tiao relayed his request, but Emperor Zizong refused. Huang then directly made an offer to Emperor Zizong, requesting to be the military governor of Lingnan East, under the opposition of the senior official Yu Kong. However, Emperor Zizong also refused, instead, at the chancellor's advice, offering to make Huang an imperial guard general. Huang, receiving the offer, was incensed by what he perceived to be an insult. In fall 879, he attacked Lingnan East's capital Guang Prefecture, capturing it after a one-day siege and taking Li Tiao captive. He ordered Li Tiao to submit a petition to Emperor Zizong on his behalf again, but this time, Li Tiao refused, so he executed Li Tiao. The Arab historian Abu Zaid Hassan of Saraf reports when Huang Chao captured Guang Prefecture, his army killed a large number of foreign merchants resident there, Muslims, Jews, Christians, and Parsis. The ethnicity of the killed were reported to be Persians, Arabs, and Jews. However, Chinese sources do not mention the alleged massacre. Mulberry groves were ruined by his army. March back north, however, as Huang Chao's army was in the Lingnan region, his soldiers were stricken by illnesses, and some 30 to 40% died. His key subordinates suggested that he march back north, and he agreed. He thus made rafts at Gui Prefecture and took them down the Xiang River, reaching Hunan's capital Tan Prefecture in winter 879. He attacked Han Prefecture and captured it in a day, and Li Shi fled to Lang Prefecture. Shang Rang then attacked Jingyan's capital Jiangling Municipality, where Wang Duo was. Wang panicked and fled as well, leaving the city to be defended by his officer Lu Hanhong, but as soon as Wang left the city, Lu mutinied, pillaged the city, and took his soldiers to become bandits. Huang himself followed Zhang's advance and went through Jiangling to attack Zhang Yang, the capital of Shannon East Circuit. He was, however, defeated by the joint forces of Shannon East's military governor Lu Jurong and the imperial general Cao Quangzhen, who further pursued him all the way to Jiangling. However, Lu, concerned that if he captured Huang, the imperial government would no longer value him, called off the pursuit, and Cao also broke off his pursuit. Huang then headed east and attacked Ti Prefecture, and pillaged the 15 surrounding prefectures. As he did, however, he was repeatedly repelled by Zhang Lin. As a result of Zhang's successes, the imperial government put Zhang's superior Gao Pian, who had by that point been transferred to Huainan Circuit, in charge of the overall operations against Huang, replacing Wang. Many circuits thus sent troops to Huainan with his forces repeatedly defeated by Zhang and also suffering from plagues. Huang, then stationed at Xin Prefecture, decided to try to bribe his way out of his predicament. He thus submitted much gold to Zhang and wrote letters to plead with Gao, offering to submit to Tang imperial authority. Gao, who also wanted to use trickery himself to capture Huang, offered to recommend Huang as a military governor. Further, Gao, in order to monopolize the achievement, decided to return the supplementary troops from Zhao Yi, Ganhua, and Yiwu circuits. As soon as he returned those troops, however, Huang broke off negotiations and challenged Zhang to a battle. Gao, in anger, ordered Zhang to engage, but this time, Huang decisively defeated Zhang in spring 880 and killed him in battle, throwing Gao into a panic. Huang, after defeating Zhang, then captured Shan Prefecture, then, in summer 880, crossed the Yangtze River north of Kaishi, and put the Huainan defense outpost Tianchang and Lua under siege, not far from Gao's headquarters at Yang Prefecture. Bai Shijue, who was then serving as an officer under Gao, suggested that Gao engage Huang. But Gao was terrified of engaging Huang after Zhang's death, and instead sent urgent requests for aid to the imperial government. The imperial government, which had hoped that Gao would be successful in stopping Huang, was very disappointed and thrown into a panic itself. Emperor Zizong ordered the circuits south of the Yellow River to send troops to Yin River to block off Huang's further advance, and also sent Cao and Chi Kurang, the military governor of Taining Circuit, to intercept Huang. However, Cao was only given 6,000 men, and although he fought hard, he was ultimately unable to stop Wang's 150,000 men. At this point, a mutiny among the imperial armies further ended any imperial resistance at Yin River. This occurred as some 3,000 Ganhua soldiers were heading to Yin River to participate in the defense operations there, and they went through Zhou Prefecture, the capital of Zhongwu Circuit. Despite the Ganhua soldiers' reputation for lack of discipline, Zhu Neng, the military governor of Zhongwu, because he had been Ganhua's military governor before, believed that they would be obedient to him, so he allowed them to stay in the city. But that night, the Ganhua soldiers rioted over what they perceived to be the lack of supplies given to them. Zhu met them and calmed them down. But this in turn caused the Zhongwu soldiers and the populace of Zhu Prefecture to be angry at his lenient treatment of them. The Zhongwu officer Zhou Ji, himself then taking Zhongwu soldiers toward Yin River, thus turned his army around and attacked and slaughtered the Ganhua soldiers. His soldiers also killed Zhu and Xue's family. Zhou then declared himself military governor. Qi, concerned that Zhou would attack him, withdrew from the area and returned to Taining Circuit. In response, the troops that other circuits had stationed at Yin River scattered, leaving the path wide open for Huang. Huang thus crossed the Huai River north, and it was said that starting from this point, Wang's army stopped pillaging for wealth, but forced more young men into the army to increase its strength. Capture of Luoyang and Chang'ara's winter 880 began. Huang Chao headed toward Luoyang and Chang'ar, and issued a declaration that his aim was to capture Emperor Zizong to make Emperor Zizong answer for his crimes. Qi Kurang was put in charge of making a final attempt to stop Huang from reaching Luoyang. Meanwhile, though, the chancellors Du Lujuan and Sui Hang, believing that imperial forces would not be able to stop Huang from reaching Luoyang and Chang'er, suggested that Emperor Zizong prepare to flee to Zhechuan Circuit, where Chen Jingshan, the brother of the powerful eunuch Tian Lingzi, was military governor. Emperor Zizong, however, wanted to also make one last attempt to defend Tong Pass between Luoyang and Chang'er, and therefore sent the Imperial Shen's army officers Zhang Chengfan, Wang Shenhui, and Zhao Kei, whose soldiers were ill-trained and ill-equipped. As the Shen's army soldiers' families were largely wealthy and were able to pay the poor and the sick to fill in for them, to try to defend it. Meanwhile, Luoyang fell quickly, and Qi withdrew to Tong Pass as well, and submitted an emergency petition stating that his troops were fatigued, hungry, and without supplies, with no apparent imperial response. Huang then attacked Tong Pass. Qi and Zhang initially resisted his forces for more than a day, but thereafter, Qi's troops, hungry and tired, scattered and fled. Zhang's final attempts to defend Tong Pass were futile, and it fell. Meanwhile, Tian had recruited some new soldiers, who were also ill-trained but relatively well-equipped, and sent him to the front. But by the time they reached there, Tong Pass had already fell, and the troops from Boy Army and Feng Xiang Circuit, also sent to the front to try to aid Zhang, became angry at the good equipment that Tian's new soldiers had, and mutinied, instead serving as guides for Wang's forces. Emperor Zizong and Tian abandoned Chang'er and fled towards Zhechuan Circuit on January 8, 881. Later that day, Wang's forward commander Chai Kun entered Chang'er, and the Tang general Zhang Jifang welcomed Huang into the capital. Shang Rang issued a declaration proclaiming Wang's love for the people, and urging the people to carry on their daily affairs. But despite Shang's assurance that the people's properties would be respected, Wang's soldiers were pillaging the capital repeatedly. Huang himself, briefly, lived at Tian's mansion, moving into the Tang Palace several days later. He also ordered that Tang's imperial clan members be slaughtered.